Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's Girl Vanelungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. So today I'm going to be reacting to Imam Omar reviving a dead heart Friday sermon. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. So without wasting time, and this video is going to be in three parts, so without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nastahdi wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi al-azim min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فعليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا منهم ومن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر آمين يا رب العالمين وأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل وقد أمرنا بالحق وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, declaring His perfection and bearing witness that none has the right to be worshipped or unconditionally obeyed except for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Him to send His peace and blessings upon His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His family, His companions, and those that follow until the Day of Judgment. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst them. Allahumma ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, it's Friday. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives everyone a choice on Friday. Most people say, thank God it's Friday because it's a chance to now go and relax and party for the weekend. And Muslims say, thank God it's Jum'ah for the chance to come and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this comparison in the Qur'an. And you know, it's not just on Black Friday that you have people that are out there looking for their dunya and are seeking some sort of satisfaction or some sort of happiness. But it's every single day, and especially every single Friday, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ O you who believe, when the call for Friday is made, when the Friday prayer has been announced, rush to the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rush to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and abandon all form of trade. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ That's actually better for you if only you knew. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking obviously to the entire ummah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also addressing the best generation that has ever walked the face of the earth, and that is the sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I mean, included in this ayah are those great people, those amazing people. But obviously with every single generation and with every single peoples, you have some that incline more towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and some that want to do business. And so there were hypocrites that existed at that time as well. And in fact, with the establishment of Salat al-Jum'ah, it did not come until the Madani phase, until the period of Medina, which is where all of the ayats, all of the verses were revealed in regards to hypocrisy, because in Mecca there was no reason to be a hypocrite. If you were a Muslim, It meant that you were going to be tortured. It meant that you were going to be run out of your home. It meant that you were going to be a social outcast. It meant that you were going to be boycotted. It meant all of those things to be Muslim, and it had no perks to being Muslim in Mecca. I mean, there was no bandwagon of Muslims in Mecca. If you were Muslim, you suffered. But whenever we look at the Madani phase, when the Prophet ﷺ establishes his state, you had then people that tried to take advantage of the situation. And so they only showed their faces at religious events and at religious gatherings when there was a worldly benefit involved. If there was no worldly benefit, there was no reason for them to be there. And in fact, that's why the Prophet ﷺ said that the most difficult prayers for the hypocrites are Fajr and Isha. Not because they're tired, not because they're sleepy, not because, you know, not because of any other reason, except that going to Fajr and Isha in those days meant that no one was going to see you. If everyone could please move up, inshallah. That no one was going to see you at the mosque. No one was going to see you praying. Because there was no lighting in the masjid. There was, you know, people would not socialize, generally speaking, at Fajr or Isha. And we find many incidents where people were killed at Salatul Fajr, and others were not even aware because it was pitch black. So the hypocrites felt no need to come to Fajr or Isha because there was going to be no worldly benefit whatsoever. They weren't going to get any dunya out of it. They weren't going to get any sense of reputation out of it. So they would only show their faces whenever their faces would be seen. And Rasulullah ﷺ said for that reason, that those two prayers are hardest on the hypocrites. And the Prophet ﷺ said in an authentic hadith from Abu Umama, Bashir al-Mashya'een, give glad tidings to those who used to walk in the dhulm, in the dhulumat, in the darkness, to the masajid of a long reaching light on the Day of Judgment. Those people that walked even when there was no need to go to the masjid from a worldly perspective. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if there was meat being distributed in the masjid, or some form of money, then you would see everyone rushing to the masjid. And this is something that was tested by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Abu Huraira one time goes to the marketplace and he tells the people in the marketplace, the inheritance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being distributed in the masjid. Halumu, go ahead and rush. Rush to the masajid. The inheritance of the prophets are being distributed. And so everyone shut their shops and ran to the masjid, and they didn't find anything. So they went back to Abu Huraira to complain to him. They said, oh Abu Huraira, was this some kind of trick that you pulled so that you could dominate the market? What was that all about? You know, when everything is shut down, you've got the few people that'll go out there and that will sell a few products here and there, and they'll make a killing because everyone else is shut down today. So what was that all about? And Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, well, did you go to the masjid? They said, we went to the masjid. Abu Huraira said, what did you find? They said, we found these circles of Qur'an, halaqat of Qur'an and hadith and fiqh. You know, these different gatherings of knowledge. And Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, that's the inheritance of the prophets. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the prophets do not leave behind any form of dirham or any form of dinar. They don't leave behind any currency. They leave behind knowledge as a form of inheritance, and whoever acquires that knowledge has acquired something beneficial indeed, has acquired something that is great. And whoever is forbidden from it has been forbidden from something that is great. What does that show you? Naturally, when we come to religion, when we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have a goal in mind. And a lot of times we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with strings attached. And when those conditions don't exist and when those circumstances cease to exist, then we fail to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anymore. And Allah azza wa jalla says to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَإِذَا رَأَوْ تِجَارَةً أَوْ لَهْوًا انْفَضُّوا إِلَيْهَا وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا. If they see a better business opportunity or they see some form of trade or an opportunity to make some money, they would rush towards that. وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا. And they would leave you, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, standing there. قُلْ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ اللَّهْوِ وَمِنَ التِّجَارَةِ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. Say that which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is better than all forms of amusement and all forms of trade. And Allah is the best of those who give in the first place. Allah is the one who grants you your sustenance in the first place. All of this is to teach us a very valuable lesson. And that lesson is not that we should become ascetics to the point that we don't do business anymore, that we don't do trade anymore. It was the Prophet ﷺ who said that the most beloved places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of the earth are the masajid, are the mosques. And the most hated places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the aswaq, are the places, are the marketplaces. And the Prophet ﷺ, though he said that, the Prophet ﷺ was in the suq. He was trading in the marketplace. The companions were trading in the marketplace. People were there. But at the same time, there was an understanding that life is not there. Life is here. Why? Why did the Prophet ﷺ even make that comparison in the first place? Because a place that is devoid of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it is a large location, whether it is a marketplace, and back then you didn't have clubs and things of that sort, nightclubs, whatever it is, a place that is devoid of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a place that contributes to the death of the heart. Is a place where a person finds himself spiritually deflated. And a place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned. A place where Allah is remembered. And our priorities are rearranged to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has demanded that they be. Then the heart finds life. And subhanAllah, just think about that for a moment. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no people gather to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that the angel...
Very interesting. One quick question. Why is it that Muslims have chosen Friday as the day they put everything aside and just have their prayers? So what's so special about Friday? Why not any other day? It could be Monday, it could be Sunday, it could be Tuesday, Wednesday. Why Friday? And it's really true. Many of us, not just the Islamic religion, but other religions as well, or religious events as well, many people don't want to attend them if they're not gaining anything. Oh, there's no snacks, I don't think I'll attend that. Oh, that we're not winning prizes, I don't think I'll attend that. Oh, my friend is not going, I don't think I'll attend that. We've made these religious events all about worldly things. How about just going there and appreciating God for once? And it's actually still happening right now that people only attend certain religious events if there is something beneficial, and that shouldn't be the way. And this is what Muhammad was trying to show them.